talk a little baseball. Larry Walker retired from baseball after the 2005 season, meaning this was his 10th and final year on the Hall of Fame ballot. Yesterday, he got the call he'd been waiting for. Take a listen.
Hello, may I speak with Larry Walker, please?
Oh. You're speaking to him.
Hi, Larry. This is Jack O'Connor with the Baseball Writers Association of America in New York.
Yes, sir.
I'm calling to let you know that you did not fall short this time.
Oh, my God.
So the Rockies followed that up with this Hall of Fame player, Hall of Fame shirt.
He tweeted about 4 hours before he got that call that he thought he was going to come up just short. And the people that tracked these things, it did look like he was going to come up literally like 8 votes short. And I believe him, he thought he was going to come up short because he was wearing the SpongeBob SquarePants like NASCAR outfit. I don't think he expected to be doing a bunch of major interviews.
Quite a buildup, having someone film you and the family and everything, if there's even a chance
that you may not get the call.
So he got the call and then he gathered everybody.
Wearing that shirt is kind of like Nick picking the 49ers. Like, it's sort of like he's hedging on it. He doesn't think it's going to happen. He's hoping it happens. It's kind of in the same space.
I haven't picked anyone. I haven't picked the Niners, nor have I picked the Chiefs. You mentioned people filming it. I know I'm a weird guy. I'm going to make one other observation. Listen, folks, only one. The three people were camera phoning that thing. Live in the moment you're in. One person can film it so he has it for posterity. Everyone else, Larry Walker's invited you to his home to share what could be the greatest moment of his life with him. It's not for Facebook. It's not for your Twitter feed or Instagram. Live in the moment.
Have you been to a concert today?
No, well, or a kid's play, or any of these things. You know what's the best HD screen in the world? Your eyeballs. Just bask in that moment instead of this. Too much of this.
Remember when we saw that video of you winning with the Chiefs? Remember when they
were in your living room? Yeah, that was not me videotaping.
I wish they'd gotten a better angle.
That
was if we could have gotten a couple more angles, I mean, I would have felt better.
No, but I agree with you. Wholeheartedly.
Oh, clearly.
Let's get back to Jimmy Garoppolo. Back in 2017, the Patriots traded him to the 49ers for a second round pick. Looking back, some would say the Niners got the best of that deal since they're Super Bowl bound and with Brady's future so uncertain. But a column in the Boston Globe says it actually worked out well for both teams. Coach, you think the Patriots should regret having dealt Jimmy Garoppolo?
No, not at all. When you look at how this has played out, so Garoppolo got there and they won 5 games late, and then he got hurt, and then they won 4 games. So there's been very little production up to this year in terms of success, especially considering how much money he got paid, how much resources they had to commit, the 49ers had to commit, including the draft picks that they sent. So you fast forward to this year, and it's not like he's been the reason that they've won in the playoffs. He threw a record low or close to a record low amount of attempts last game. So you can't even look at it from that perspective. And then when you go to New England, they won 1 Super Bowl. They went to a 2nd Super Bowl. They won another division championship. So there's been a consistent amount of success there. Now, in terms of the draft picks they've got, they've drafted 6 guys that have played a total of 100 snaps from that trade. So they really haven't gotten much done from the draft capital that they got.
So
from
people
Jimmy
understand
Garoppolo.
What Coach talking about. They got 1 pick for him, the 42nd pick. They then have flipped that 5 different ways, and so that's how they've gotten.
Yeah,
6
and
players.
And those 6 players have now produced a total of 100 snaps. Total.
So almost no current return for the player.
Yeah, their return is that they didn't have to pay him a lot of money. That's really the only return they've gotten to this point. Now, we'll see how these players play out over time. But when you look at the deal in its entirety, yeah, I guess you could say they came out relatively equal.
Yeah, I mean, here's the deal. I mean, it was a short-term play for the New England Patriots, and I say that because they decided to roll with Tom Brady rather than ripping the Band-Aid and going with Jimmy G, and Tom Brady is getting ready to turn 40 years old. I mean, so when we go back 27 months, we're looking at it from that standpoint. Okay, Robert Kraft basically told Bill Belichick that you have to trade Jimmy G because I'm not going to let you walk away from Tom Brady. But in those 2 years, the Patriots have what? They've gone to two Super Bowls, delivered one championship, and Tom Brady's had an MVP season. So, I mean, I feel like the Patriots got what they were looking for in terms of being able to maximize the twilight of Tom Brady's career. And then, of course, the 49ers, they made the move with the long-term vision in mind. And, yeah, the first 2 years didn't go great for Jimmy G, but in the third year with the club, in his second full season, you're talking about a Super Bowl appearance. You can debate whether or not he's the reason that they're there, but I think Jimmy G has proven that he's good enough to have your team compete at a championship level because they're in the big game. So I think it's worked out from that standpoint for both organizations because they both got what they were looking for.
I want to make the Patriots obviously did the right thing with the benefit of hindsight as far as sticking with Tom Brady, okay? Like, the year they traded Jimmy Garoppolo, Tom Brady won league MVP and threw for 500 yards in the Super Bowl. Now, they lost it, but that wasn't his fault. The next year, they won the Super Bowl. And while he was not great at the end of that season nor great in the Super Bowl, he did, you know, go to Kansas City against one of the three highest-scoring offenses ever and lead a fourth-quarter comeback and then lead a touchdown drive in overtime. I am not prepared to say Jimmy Garoppolo would have done that. If they would have moved on, that Jimmy Garoppolo would have put them in that position. And obviously for the Niners, we can say what they should have done is never trade for Jimmy Garoppolo. What they should have done is in the 2017 draft when they were sitting in number two and they traded back to three, draft Deshaun Watson, or, you know, after Mitch Trubisky comes off the board, draft Patrick Mahomes and ruin my life, like whatever, however you want to do it.
They went but with Solomon Thomas.
They went with Solomon Thomas, who of all their first-round pick defensive linemen has been the least productive up to this point. My only gripe with the trade for New England is Belichick, to me, did something he very rarely does, which is acted somewhat irrationally. He had a better offer on the board from Cleveland. A first-round pick from Cleveland that ended up being the 12th overall pick. It was actually Philly's pick that year. Like, it's complicated, but it was a first-round pick. And instead, he took a second-round pick. Why? Conflicting reports, because he wanted to make sure Jimmy G landed softly because of a long-term grudge with Cleveland, because he was so upset he was having his hand forced by the owner that he didn't put the care into this trade. He would have trade that was of his own volition, whatever it was. But had he taken the better offer, they'd have the succession plan in place. Because that 12th overall pick ended up being Deshaun Watson. The Texans ended up trading for it themselves. Like, they could have had their quarterback right there. And even if they don't, they would have had a player who was a top 15 talent, a top 12 person on their board, who would have been in year two of his contract this year, who would have been helping them, who absolutely would have helped them more than the six people they ended up getting for the 100 snaps for the 42nd overall pick.
Well, do we know that that was absolutely an offer on the table? A lot of times, after the fact, people say, well, we were going to draft this guy, or we were willing to trade this. And the truth is somewhere in the middle. It's nowhere near as definitive as people make it out in the moment.
So I obviously am not the one reporting this. What I do know is the beat reporters in Cleveland and New England have both independently said, Ben Volin wrote it in this article we're talking about, Cleveland writers wrote it at the time, that Cleveland was upset the Patriots did not take their offer of a first-round pick. Or the Patriots did not even, I think one report was that they didn't accept it. The other ones, the Patriots didn't even call them back about it. So they did not get a good enough return. Your point is that their best return was they didn't have to pay him. So they didn't get a much better return than had they just cut him. And he just goes to San Francisco on their own.
Well, look, that's the risk you take anytime you trade a current player for a future asset. You got to be right on the pick. And they did get Jared Stidham in this, so who knows how that plays out long term. And these other guys eventually could develop into something really good. Now, trading a player in the AFC, sometimes you don't want to do that, because if you really believe that this is a very good player with a lot of potential, the last thing you want to do is have to deal with them with more frequency than you need to. You can control where he goes, and this gave him a chance to, at least if you're going to face him in the really meaningful game, it's going to be in the Super Bowl.
All right, we'll leave it there. Coach, stick around. Coming up, can the Dallas Cowboys still compete for a Super Bowl if they break the bank for Dak Prescott? That's next. This is First Things First.
Didn't y'all trade Bledsoe?